And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome cancer survivor, doctor, filmmaker, and most of all, proud Penn Stater and supporter of Thon and Ryan McGarry.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone, so much. I'm actually going to give this back to Leah for a second. You're sharing that. So, thank you for that amazing speech and for this incredible award, of which I am so honored to receive. And also, thank you to the Hope Gala for continuing to fight for what we all believe in as Penn Staters, but most importantly, as crusaders against cancer. Also just want to recognize, too, some very, thank you. Thanks. One of the things that gets you through life, Leah, is not only an awesome dad, like Devin, but great friends, and I've got a table of amazing friends over here, and I just want to say thank you guys for being there for me all the way. My best friends are from Penn State, naturally. So, thank you guys. And also Dan Coco for Board of Trustees. What? Was that legal? I don't know. What I wanted to share tonight is a bit of an update on cancer. I am a proud executive producer of CBS's Code Black, Wednesday night at 10, 9 Central. But I'm still a practicing physician. I fly back from LA twice a month to work often weekend nights, and I really believe in what I do at the bedside and what we do as physicians. And one thing you may not realize is that going forward, one of the more interesting areas of cancer research is one of sort of a coexistence with cancer. The idea being that in the future, we may not eradicate the disease outright. It may not be chemotherapies that blast those cells, but also the good cells that we have too, but maybe individual sort of gene-modulated techniques that sort of allow us to just sort of keep cancer in check. And that means that we may never, in the future, cure cancer at times. We may just decide that we can find ways to turn down the volume of it and let it sort of just be there, and at the same time not subject the patient to enormous toxicity and trauma. Well, what interests me about that is cancer has sort of always been a part of us. One of the things that you realize about this disease that's so special is that it's not some outside distant invader like a bacteria or a virus that comes from God knows where and lands inside us and then takes over. Cancer almost always starts within our cells. It is our very makeup that starts to reject us. It is you beating up you. And how ironic and special at once. And so this next part, Leah, is just for you. It's just for you, hon. And it's stuff you may not remember tonight, but it's, I hope, something that you take with you for the rest of your life. And that is that you won't ever really be done with cancer. You hopefully will be done with the treatments, and you may never have to go back to an oncologist again. But you'll never really be done with it because it's made you special. And it'll always be great reasons that you're special. Sometimes you'll doubt yourself. Sometimes you'll wonder about what's ahead. But most importantly, that specialness will make you different. And that difference, which is often manifest in bravery, is what will make you so unique in this world. So Leah, you're so brave. And what you gonna do with that bravery? You've already done for us so much. But I know you got more in you. What's it gonna be? Are you gonna stop a bully someday because you're different and you're brave? Yeah? Maybe? Are you gonna become an amazing businesswoman or an amazing scientist and run a corporation? Maybe? Yeah? Are you gonna start your own mediocre rated network television show? Maybe? Leah, look at all those gold specks up there, Leah. Look at all of them. And there's a wall for you. Those are all stars that you might be able to reach someday, whether you decide to pilot to Mars or change all of our lives here. You, for the next year and 1,000 years, will always be special and be different. And I, for one, will always be there with you. Thank you so much for this reward, and thank you, Hope Gala. Good night.